She is going in having done it before. I feel like this 2022 election is going to be slightly different for Stacey Abrams. So Stacey Abrams in 2018, after her loss, or what I would argue the election stolen from her, she did what no other Democrat did who lost their respective general elections, and that she rolled up her sleeves and got to work. And by that, I mean she and Fair Fight, the organization that she started, really did work on institutional barriers that have prevented voters across the country from participating in free and fair elections. And so she wasn't just targeting Democrats. She was targeting people who have been removed from democracy, disproportionately Democrats, disproportionately people of color, disproportionately poor people, disproportionately people who are immigrants and recently new citizens. And so when you think about the key states where Fair Fight worked to shore up free and fair elections, places like Wisconsin and Pennsylvania and Arizona and Georgia, we saw the fruits of her labor in 2020 when those states actually had people who were able to go to the polls and not see as many institutional barriers that prevented them from participating in a presidential election, but also, depending on the state, elections for senators, obviously they're members of Congress, members of the House of Representatives, sometimes even governors. So 2022 looks a little differently in the sense that Stacey Abrams doesn't really know which challenger she'll have just yet. And we know that Republicans have been working diligently over the past few years to make sure that they erode some of the progress that's been made to make sure that people can participate freely in elections. But she is going in having done it before. And we all know that, you know, your first time at the rodeo is a little different than the second time around, even if the players are somewhat different. I think there's another non-institutional, somewhat institutional barrier that Stacey Abrams has a different vantage point. And that's, you know, when she ran in 2018, because we've never had a Black female governor, many people just said, well, she's not going to win, so I'm not going to participate. They supported her, but they didn't necessarily think that their vote would matter. I think seeing how close she came will hopefully mobilize some people who stood on the sidelines, who didn't necessarily participate in 2018, to recognize that they too can actually make this change.
Stacey's been preparing for this her entire adult life. I was an early advisor to the New Georgia Project. I helped craft the report that was used to validate externally that Stacey's strategy for long-term investment in Georgia made sense when I was at the Center for American Progress. So I was not surprised that Stacey bounced back, because for her, you know, the prize is never the position, as she would say, it's the progress. And she's been building a movement. Somebody asked me, you know, how I would compare Stacey Abrams' movement this year in Georgia to Obama's nationally in 2008. I said, well, the difference is Obama wasn't trying to change the American electorate in 1998 so he could run for president 10 years later. But 10 years ago, Stacey was trying to change the Georgia electorate to prepare for this moment. And Stacey, of course, has won three statewide races now. For Biden, for Warnock, for Ossoff, by changing that electorate. And so she starts off in many ways in a very strong position. Now, like the gladiators of ancient Rome, she's been paired against somebody who's every bit her equal, because he is as evil and devious as she is, you know, good and planful. He, Governor Kemp has been vote suppressor in chief in Georgia since before he was governor, all the way back to when he was Secretary of State. And, you know, like a virus that keeps mutating, he keeps trying to improve his dastardly plans. I mean, he's as close to the James Bond grade villain as you will find in American politics. And as an organizer in the civil rights movement, I've worked with Stacey for now, well, I turned 49 in January. That'll make 30 years that we have worked together. And as a organizer, I've always been excited to be supportive of her plans. In 2020, she enlisted People for the American Way under my leadership as one of the 10 groups most responsible, 10 national groups most responsible for helping turn out voters in Georgia and transform the electorate. And, you know, that's been my role with Stacey for 30 years. I've always been happy to be a friend, helper, a fellow organizer. You know, I was walking national press through Georgia in 2014, explaining to them why Stacey Abrams' plans made sense, you know, long before anybody else was co-signing on them outside of Georgia.